Ms. Gasser.
I have some information on the subpoenas.
Let's go.
We did receive copies of the subpoenas, and we tracked this. There were six, as I understand it. And let me just say at the outset, our members have concerns about this exercise for three reasons. The subpoenas yielded information about members of Congress. Whether they're subpoenaed the members' phone records or not, it's a concern when the information yields member of Congress's phone records, and then the information is publicized. Second is with journalists. It's just generally a very tricky area to start investigating journalists' call records. And the third is with regard to Mr. Giuliani, who was serving as the president's personal attorney. But there's six subpoenas, as we understand it. The first went to AT&T for the Giuliani numbers. The second was in regard to Igor Fruman, to a company, CSC Holdings. The third related to Mr. Sondland. That was off to Verizon. The fourth was back to AT&T, seeking information on a certain number. The fifth was back to AT&T, and the sixth was seeking subscriber information, which impacted the veteran journalist John Solomon. And also involved with these are some, you know, some of the attorneys involved, such
as Ms. Gasser, can I ask you a question?
Ms. Tunsing and Geneva.
Ms. Gasser, you've been a veteran of the Hill investigation for 15 years, and this is crazy. I've never seen anything like this. You never have either. Would it be interesting to note, because Mr. Goldman chooses not to answer because he doesn't want to incriminate, I believe, either himself or the chairman or somebody else. Would it be interesting to you to find, as you've dealt with committee staff for a long time, somebody to just have an epiphany just to do those match records on their own, or were they under direction by somebody to do that?
Well, it's obviously they were trying to figure something out.
That's it. All right, one last, I'm getting ready to try. Wait, I have one thing for Mr. Goldman. Mr. Goldman, we're used to committees and people and witnesses coming, taking gratuitous shots at people they don't like. And earlier today, in your testimony, you made a comment that really goes with an interesting thing, and I'll even go back to the chairman questioning motive. When your testimony, you said, as you were discussing Mr. Sondland, you made a very snide comment, your facial expression showed, that he was a $1 million donor to the president. The implication being he either got his job because he bought it, or his implication was he was loyal to the president and say anything about it. Be very careful about how you throw around dollars in giving, because you and Mr. Burke are real heavy donors to the Democratic Party, and I'm not going to say it questions your motive or your position here today, but we need to make sure that this thing is already blown out of proportion. We're already not answering questions, and you are here without a pen because your chairman will not testify. That says all we need to hear. He don't even stand behind his own report, and he sends you. I hope it works out for you. I'm done. At this point, I turn it over to Ashley.
Could I respond? Are you trying to say that I what are you trying to say? What is the implication here? But by the way, I didn't give anything close to $1 million remotely, so I don't know.
The implication is we want Schiff in that chair, not you. The implication is the person that wrote the report is the person that should come and present it, and you weren't elected by anybody, and you're here giving this testimony in place of the chairman. I hope that clears up the implication.
The gentleman does not have the time, and the gentleman has been warned before. He cannot simply yell out and disrupt the committee. The gentleman, Mr. Collins, has the time.
I think you understand exactly what you did. And I called it out for just the way you did. You thought you were going to get by with it, and you didn't. That's all I'm saying. Ms. Ashley, Ms. Callan.
Well, I would like to just say one other thing.
I am done.
Point of order, there's no question before the gentleman.
I mean, you're casting aspersions.
No, as you did, Mr. Goldman.
Point of order.
As you did, Mr. Sondland. Now, according to the chairman's own ruling just a few minutes ago, I'm done asking questions, and I'm not asking you to elaborate because I'm not asking you any more questions. I've asked all. You won't answer the question on who told the committee to actually check these numbers. You won't say if it's you or if it's Mr. Schiff. You won't answer my questions, so we're done. We're going to Ms. Cowan. As Mr. Burke said, you'll have plenty of time with helpful majority counsel to answer
the question. Does the gentleman yield his time to Ms. Cowan?
Yes.
The gentlelady's recognized.